Good afternoon and evening, everyone. It is so great to see you all. My name is Katie Gideon, and I am calling from Houston, Texas, and I will be your facilitator this evening for our last weekly setup of May. I know I saw a couple of you guys getting really excited for June, and this is just kind of one of those weird weeks where you get part of May, part of June. So we're going to do one more kind of embracement of empowerment, but I'm going to put a little spin on it to add some spontaneity to it to embrace the next theme. But the other reason we're kind of going with May is because June, the weeklies, we're introducing a weekly activity for the weekly setups that's going to be in a series. So the entire June weekly setups, when you come to these, are going to have kind of a series of the activities that start these. So it'll be really fun, really exciting. And so for those of you who are like, I don't know which one I'm going to do, which one I'm going to work on, I have my June one here for some of my weekly setup, but I am also still using the last couple days of my May one as well, because I like to kind of keep the months a little bit separate, but obviously needed it there. So again, welcome everyone to our weekly setup. Joining me in the chat, my fellow facilitator, Miss Bailey, who is dialing in from Tennessee. We are excited to be here. And we're so excited to go through this, kind of close out, get our week set up. It's going to be a short week because the national holiday. So always love the extra days. But I also feel like that means my week's a little bit more chaotic because of it. So we are going to provide some tips and tricks for you to set up your weekly. And we will go ahead and get started. So for some grounding, if you want to share with the chat, make sure your chat is set to everyone so you can share with each other your tips and tricks for how you set up your weekly. Also self-care raffle, everyone is automatically already entered. So we're so excited. So again, embracing that final theme of empowerment. But to be honest, I was certainly ready for May to be over with, moving into a new month. I lost a lot of momentum and enthusiasm and motivation near the end of May. So I definitely took a different look to my weekly to kind of help that, as well as just kind of the monthly setup. So, but I still love the theme of empowerment that really speaks to me. So wanted to kind of spend another one more time of kind of setting up that power empowerment as we go into those. So still love it, but I'm going to say the one thing that usually gets me out of a funk pretty instantly, kind of adding that kind of temporary motivation that I need, is going to start with our activity. And it is an empowerment playlist. I'm a huge fan of playlists. It's definitely something music makes me happy. Finding the right song can take me any sort of like any mood, bad mood, good mood, all of the above. So I want you to go ahead and turn to a blank page, and I want you to list three or more songs that make you feel powerful. And I encourage you to put it in the chat, because we're going to create this really fun empowerment playlist. And then to embrace the spontaneity of it, I always listen to my music on shuffle or random. And I'm definitely one of those people, I will click through all of the songs until I find the song I want, which you're like, that totally defeats the purpose of it being on shuffle if you already know what song you want to hear or what song you want. But it's still just that fun magic of like, I don't know what's going to come next, but I mean, I kind of do. But it's just that excitement of like, I feel like telepathically my music is like, here's the songs that you need, and we're going to play all these right now. So that's what we're going to go through. We're going to kind of create a really fun playlist. I'm from the mixtape and burn CD generation. So I feel like that was always something that I did. And it was like a fun summer activity that I did with my friends, making all those, listening to the radio, recording the songs off the radio. So also an opportunity for you to come up with like a really fun summer playlist, but also embracing the empowerment. What are those songs that you just want to crank up? Sing at the top of your lungs, dance like nobody's watching, and we'll share this in the chat to kind of come up with. It's just like a quick, you know, straightforward, pretty easy opening activity to get us going. So I'm going to turn on some music here, and we will see you in a minute. Thank you. Wow. Great minds think alike. I loved seeing all of your suggestions. I think every genre was represented. Quite a few of the songs that were listed, I have listed already kind of on my empowerment playlist on Spotify, as well as Spontaneity. So loved seeing all of these. Love just the opportunity to share music. I feel like music can be a little bit of a universal language. I'm definitely one of those that makes me happy, but definitely saw some of what I would consider the classic empowerment ladies, Gloria Gaynor, Chaka Khan, Kelly Clarkson, Katy Perry. I feel like all of those kind of empowering anthems that we come to associate with. And then I also realized that some people are a little hesitant to embrace the spontaneity of this month. I am definitely the queen of random Princess of Unplanned. And it's always just the little things. So putting your playlist on shuffle is a way to kind of embrace a little bit of the spontaneity. Or what's been really fun, especially if you have Spotify or Apple Tunes, you can create, it can kind of have a predetermined mix for you. So you can click just daily mix and it'll throw the music songs that it'll think you like based on your suggestions. So fun little way to boost your mood with that fun playlist, but add a little bit of spontaneity to it, just to kind of embrace a little of the unknown, because I understand that it can definitely be some triggers there for the unplanned. But like I said, it's a fun little way to do it. So thank you for indulging me on our empowerment playlist. Now we're gonna get to why you are here. So if you are in your June journal, or kind of still working off the May journal, depending on what you have, we're gonna be on the top of the page for this week, I Want to Feel. This is a really fun section that you can kind of use in whatever kind of method you want. You can think of it as, it can be an affirmation, it can be a word, it can be a feeling. Can be a scripture. You can also use stickers, pictures, just kind of what do you want to feel this time next week? Or what do you need to remind yourself to do this week? So for example, it could be this person was glowing. Prioritize is one of them. The one at the bottom was actually just a sticker for me, because I was like, I don't know how I want to feel. I just kind of need to get through this week because we were super busy, had a lot of deadlines, which I know is not always the greatest way to embrace it, but I still wanted to do it with a smile. So we are on page 26 for those of you in the June journal, week 22. That's where we are for there. But coming up with the way I want to feel. And so provided some other suggestions. So we will give you a little bit of time to kind of come up with that. Start throwing it into the group chat with how you want to feel. How do you want to approach this week? And what do you want to feel essentially this time next week?
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone, for sharing. Seeing quite a few folks wanting to get back on track, wanting to feel in control with the end of school arriving for those folks that are either educators, teachers, or have children. Relaxing, I feel like, is always a great way to kick off summer vacation. A couple other ones was Rev wanted to feel sparkling. I love that. That can be any of the above, but just I feel like it's a way to opportunity to emit that glow that just makes people notice. Jennifer also wants to feel sunny, and Stephanie is motivated. She's in a transition of life right now, so she wants to feel motivated to pursue her dreams. I love all of these. Again, this is just kind of an opportunity to sit and reflect briefly with what you want to do with this week. And then we're going to kind of add on, I feel like, the grounding notes of the to-dos, the goals, all of these things, but still that overarching idea of this is how I would like to feel this time next week at potentially the next weekly social. So now we are still on page 26, but we're moving to the weekly to-dos, which is the box on the left. And this is one of those, you can turn it into a to-do list, you can turn it into a to-da list. And people always say, what's the difference between the to-do and the to-da? Really, it's just how you mentally approach it. To-do, I tend to dread some of those. So if I turn it into a to-da list, it's a mini celebration of accomplishment as opposed to the things that I have to do. So that's how I approach the to-do and the to-da. You can also use the Eisenhower matrix. It's a great operational tool. And that's the do, decide, delegate, and delete. It is a Silk and Sonder staple. So if you haven't tried this, highly recommend giving it a try. But I feel like with the weekly to-dos, you start to kind of figure out what works for you best. This can also be a dread list. This was a suggestion that I received in a social of if I put it on a dread list, I acknowledge that it's not something I want to do. And so then I add as my weekly to-do is to complete something from my dread list. I get to pick it. And then my dread list turns into the to-da list instead of the dreaded to-do list. Or it could also be things you want to do. Maybe it's a self-care list or things you don't want to forget about for the week. You know, we've seen a couple different variations. So if you have repurposing ideas, please let us know how you use it. But again, it's certainly going to be what works for you in the to-do, to-da, dread list opportunity. Ooh, love it. Eat the frog list. Similar concept with the dread list. Here are some examples. For the one at the top, these were questions that the individual was going to ask themselves every day. So I feel like it was a great approach to this. Instead of coming up with your answers, you're coming up with questions so you can come up with those answers in real time. And then as you see, there's also an opportunity to do a to-don't list. And then my weekly to-do list is the one in the middle. Pretty boring, pretty standard. Those are the things I need to do because I'm going to be out of my apartment most of June on work-related travels. So kind of got to set all those things up for that. And then just keeping in mind, success is never getting to the bottom of your to-do list. Don't want to take that as a negative connotation, but it's the motivation to always have something to do. And then when in doubt, always put yourself at the top of your to-do list. So we'll go ahead and give you guys some time to work on this. Let us know how you're using your to-do list, or maybe you need some extra motivation to get those to-do, to-da lists done. And just share with what you want, and we'll see you in a minute. Thank you, everyone, for sharing. Eisenhower Matrix is definitely a popular option with the do, decide, delegate, and delete. I do have to acknowledge that delegation can be a little difficult. I do live by myself. It's me and my dog. Unfortunately, if I delegate her tasks, she's not very good at them. So I think of it in terms of just like little things. So I live on a second floor, and I have to take my trash downstairs to a giant bin that we throw it away in. And as I was walking to do that, one of my neighbors came at the same time, offered to take the trash for me. Normally, my super proud, powerful individual would have said, no, I got it. But I appreciated the offers. I absolutely took them up on the offer. So they kept taking my trash and I got to turn around and come back to my apartment. So I feel like it's definitely one of those, it's the little delegations. We know it can't be massive tasks, but you know, I got 5-10 minutes back just for the saunter down there. And I feel like it's always appreciated. And sometimes we get definitely in our mindset, I can certainly do things. And asking for help is always tricky for me to do. So I was very proud that I delegated that to, you know, a friend. So again, that's an option to kind of look at it that way. But I know delegation can be a little tricky. And so a couple other ones is Crystal uses her for what she needs that week. So if she needs rest, she goes to bed at 10:30, turns off her phone, all of those things that go to needing rest. And then Kimberly was off this week from work. So she used it to catch up on laundry, start working on her dream budget, decluttering her house and getting outside in nature. So as much as we want them to be tasks, they can certainly just be reminders, you know, go outside, go walk, you know. Listen to music, turn off your mind, meditate, all of those. An interesting way to do this. We always recommend trying a couple different methods until you get to the one that sticks. And also, if you don't get to it, that's perfectly okay. Give yourself the permission that if you don't accomplish everything on your to-do or to-do list, that's okay. You know, make sure you're listening and you're forgiving yourself as you go on the process, because this shouldn't be something that's anxiety inducing or triggering if you just don't get it done, because we have good weeks and we have bad weeks. We have good days. We have challenging days, and that's okay. So now moving right next to that, the weekly major three goals. So the way I approach the difference between the weekly to-dos and the weekly major three goals is I focus on my weekly to-dos, or the kind of things I need to accomplish, things I need to do. The weekly major three goals that I use are the mindset that I want, or the like emotional mental reminder that I need. So for me, it's get caught up, work out, move more, sleep in bed, or remove myself from the unimportant. Because with this, positive thinking is a mental and emotional attitude that focuses on the bright side of life and expects. Hold on, can't see my screen. And expects positive results. And so I definitely come from this mantra of making positive thinking a bit of a habit. So I always try to see the bright side of life, definitely on the optimistic side, to the point of probably painfully overly optimistic sometimes. But that's just kind of the mental reminders that I give myself of where I want to be in my headspace for that week. But as you can see here, a couple different other examples, just kind of bigger ideas. If you're coming back from vacation, maybe it's settling back into that, or the just kind of explore, hydrate, and move, use those to any definition that you want. Focusing on the to-do list, starting a to-be list. So again, that's just kind of how I particularly approach the weekly to-dos and the weekly three major goals, but would love to see how other folks approach this and how those two work hand in hand. So please share in the chat how you approach those. I'm gonna stop talking and let you keep doing some work. Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for sharing. Wanted to give you guys a little bit of extra time just to finish up the weekly to-dos, weekly goals, because I also do those kind of together. So I may jump back and forth between the two. But thank you, everyone, for sharing. Some of the other ideas there were was the explore, create, and connect from Danielle. Thought that's a very elegant way of summing it up. For Kathy, she always has relax and reconnect goals, but this week she's got revive and then usually some sort of variant of restart, rejuvenate, review. I'm a sucker for alliterations. So that's really fun and a really good way to do it, but appreciate again that mental approach to it. And then for Kelsey, she has reset, vacation and short work week last week, but then busy all weekend, focusing on health and hydration and move more. So I think these are all amazing ways to approach these goals to kind of help you get through them and working for them kind of again as they go week to week. And you can always do something that works. Try it. If it doesn't work, you can do something different. And I feel like there are times where I really just have either too much going on, too much in my brain to think. And I will usually cover it with a sticker or a doodle or just kind of a nice big color to make me happy. So again, you don't have to have three major goals. You don't even have to have one major goal. It's an opportunity to just kind of help you plan out your week, but not to the restrictions or requirements that you should be limiting yourself or setting kind of superficial boundaries. So now we are still on page 26, moving to the bottom of the habit and activity tracker. And so usually what we get kind of as a question for this is how does this kind of go with the monthly tracker? And my particular approach is for the monthly tracker, those are things I want to do each day. And then the weekly is where I can pull some of those monthly ones and give it a specific, you know, time period. So I want to walk and move or work out every day, but based on, you know, weather, real life commitments during that week, I will then modify to maybe I'm only have the opportunity to work out like 30 minutes each day, or, you know, an hour each day. Or if I want to read, maybe I add, you know, two or three chapters that I want to read. I add kind of that quantification. But then it's also an opportunity for me to try out kind of new or fun habits that I want to see if it's something I can do, something I can work on, or something I want to focus on that week. So sing out loud is one of them. You know, dance like no one's watching, sleep in my bed because I notoriously have really bad sleeping habits. And then, like I said, because I'm traveling a lot this month, my walk Annie habit is going to be removed because she's not going to be here. So it's an opportunity. I'm going to have to find another habit. And another kind of great tool with this is a 5-4-3-2-1 approach. You can do, you know, something that you want five times, something you want to do four times, three times, two, and then one. Here are some other options for like an evening self-care checklist. You can use this as like a daily morning ritual, an evening ritual, but also you don't have to use all five of them. Maybe you just have the ability to do two. Maybe you need to start small. Maybe you need to start a little simple. That's perfectly fine. There definitely have been times where I've only done two or three, and that's okay. So just give yourself the permission and the grace to think about what you need. What are some of those habits and activities you want to tackle? And please share in the chat how you kind of approach this. Are you a 5-4-3-2-1? I usually add up mine kind of in real time at the end of the week, see how much I accomplished. And if you need some ideas on kind of habits to try, here is the habit tracker ideas that we provide in the monthly. So an opportunity to incorporate some of these, but you can take any approach that you want. So I'm going to go ahead and give you guys some time to approach this habit activity tracker at the bottom for the week on page 26.
Thank you.
you all. These are such great approaches to the habit activity trackers. I have definitely learned so much in a couple of minutes here. And I was definitely, that's the reason I joined Silicon Sounder, was for the habit tracker, mood trackers, all the accountability. But you guys have absolutely given me ideas to completely turn everything that I thought about this approach into something different, something magical. So a couple of the other ideas to share is Vienna says she's actually using her whole spread this week on feelings of relax. So goals, to-dos, habits, even everything on the next page that we're getting ready to approach, all of those things are going to be with the one end goal in mind, is to relax. That is an amazing approach to this entire spread. I think it's genius. I may have to embrace one of these emotions, in some sort of week. I'm so excited. And then Lisa, sometimes she just puts a sticker over the word goal and over the word total. Love that, because sometimes a step in any direction is a step, it's movement. Progress is progress is relative. So this is a wonderful approach. So I feel like give yourself that realistic kind of mental pep talk. So they're not using this as like a tool against you of what you didn't accomplish. And then another really great idea was Kelsey. She added a learn something to her activity list. Her job requires her to continuously learn. So I think it's too much to try to do every day each month, but I like the idea of trying to learn something at least a few times a week. That is lovely. I feel like this habit activity opportunity each weekly is an opportunity to add those realistic kind of parameters that, you know, you're either busy at work, you're busy at life, you're busy in your kind of hobbies, all of those things. So to be able to change these habits weekly to give yourself the best possible way to accomplish and feel good about yourself is an amazing opportunity. And again, if you don't like something, you can try it another week, you can get rid of it. The options to have a clean slate each and every time is certainly a wonderful relief, especially if you had a bad week and you just kind of need to move on. So thank you everyone for sharing. Our next section is the meal plan. So we're just flipping over. This is now page 27. And I'm going to go with a big generalization. I usually avoid generalizations, but I see this as one of the more popular ones to repurpose. We definitely have those folks that treat this absolutely as a meal planner for families themselves, et cetera. We also have folks that do this in real time to track kind of, I've used it when I had ulcerative colitis flare. So I used it to track what I ate, how I felt about it. So then I was able to present those symptoms to my doctor. So I've listed a couple repurposing ideas that we've seen on the left-hand side. The one in the middle is a house cleanup schedule, if you will. The one in the middle are actually all of the daily affirmations copied from the app. And then the one on the far right with kind of the glittery celestial back border, that is actually one that I used when I was traveling to a work conference. I wrote down everything I was going to wear each of those days to help me with packing. And I am a packing procrastinator, but this tool made me pack efficiently. Didn't have to think about it too much because I wrote this out over the course of a week. Also kept it down to one single carry-on bag and nothing was really wrinkled. So it was an opportunity to reuse some of those because I am definitely like a panic packer where it's like, of course I need 5 t-shirts and, you know, 6 pairs of shorts for a 2-day trip. So I've used this as that tool. I've also used it as a study guide, but I have work-related travel that I'm gonna do. So I'm absolutely gonna use this method again. It was a suitcase carry on. So before we get like, I didn't go duffel bag or backpack style. I'm not that great. I can only do so much. But for me, it was a really great tool that I feel like helped. And my, you know, dad who enjoys any sort of matrix, any sort of packing maneuver would have been really impressed with my ability to condense as much as I did. Those are just kind of some ideas that we have. Please share in the chat how you repurpose this. And again, these are just different options that folks have. And the washi tape is great. And then I know that for a while I didn't touch the meal plan. I didn't know what to do with it. I didn't know how to do it. So it was just something that I got to work and tweak. So please share how you repurpose or how you use it. thank you everyone for sharing their repurposing. Love seeing that Jennifer with school being out, she's going to use it to plan where her son will be on each day. I think it'll be more relaxed with summer scheduling this way, so she can see it in one place, which I think is a great tool to use it. Certainly another opportunity to track someone else's schedule. And then Lisa also lists the available dishes for her to serve at each meal. Just as an option, not necessarily for the days of the week, just what gets eaten, which I think is a great tool for that. I know Jennifer O, one of our facilitators, uses it to kind of track leftovers, one, so they get eaten, and two, to make sure they're eaten before they expire. So please continue to share how you repurpose your planning, especially in the app, so that we can continue to share your ideas at upcoming socials. So now moving to the next section, the mind body health plan. So this is the top right on page 27. This is a bunch of, again, another people use this in a lot of different ways. One of the ways that you can track it is the different types of rest. There's a really nice example of each of the days that individual is taking that type of rest and incorporating that into the mind body health plan. The examples of types of rests are what's listed on the left hand of the slide. I track in real time what I've done that makes me happy for my mind or body. And then a couple other options is here's a daily self-care checklist that you can incorporate into mind body health plan options if you want to think ahead. I also came up and found another kind of weekly intentions idea with giving the day kind of a theme, how you're going to embrace it. So then you can be a little bit flexible with it. So please share with the group how you approach your mind body health plan. And then as we go, feel free to go back to previous sections that you want to focus on. If you do this in real time, if you like to plan for one of these, don't worry, Sam, I'm going to actually scroll between the two slides once I stop talking, so you'll get to see both. But put in the chat if you need me to go back and forth to one of the slides. So again, stop talking, let you guys keep working.
Thank you.
Thank you everyone for sharing your ideas for the mind body health plan. And I understand we're getting a little close on time, but if you stick around in the chat a little bit afterwards and just ask me to go back to different slides, I'll be able to reshare those kind of at the end for the final song. So let us know. But a couple really cool ideas that came up is April uses hers as a self-care alphabet, with A for aromatherapy, B for bath bombs, C for crafting, which I think is a really fun approach. I found it a little bit easier to add a little bit of structure to this section. It was far more accomplishable instead of, again, when I just kind of defaulted to the real time. But again, any sort of awesome ideas you have, please share. We love to see them. Then we come down to our shopping list at the bottom. Again, you can use this in its truest form. I also use this as like kind of the companion to my wardrobe list when I was packing. These were the extra things that I had to do. So here are different opportunities to repurpose this here. You can use it again as a shopping list, but quotes. Right now, mine is actually just a sticker. The I can, I will. It's just fun motivation because sometimes I try not to put too much in the shopping list unless it's truly something I need. It actually curbs some of my spontaneous spending, which is not a great thing, especially since I had been trying to do some serious budgeting previously. So if I don't write anything on the shopping list, there's nothing to purchase. So that's kind of been my mind frame recently, but also love seeing it as an intentions for the week. A prayer list is a fantastic thought. Oh, Amber. Yeah, spontaneity is good, but the spontaneous spending, not always good. We cannot encourage those unplanned random habits. So appreciate that, but it's definitely one of those to kind of keep yourself honest. And then with that being said, we are actually at the end of our session. So again, I want to be respectful of folks that have the time to leave, but if you want to stick around and hang out, I'll flash back some of the other slides. But please, you're going to get a survey. We read all of the feedback. This is how socials were created. This is how socials exist. This is also how our YouTube channel that has the social recordings are there. So you can always catch up on your weekly, your monthly setups, as well as the exclusive activities. If work run long, you have to leave early, you have to leave late. You can include all of those. You can see all of those from the past months as well to continue to get ideas. There is no chat available in that, but it'll be the slide deck and the facilitator. Bailey is also including all of those in the chat. And then you can also, again, if you're not already a member on our Sonder app, you can do that. And then here's a quick show of my playlist. I will throw that in the chat as well. There's a couple extra songs of just kind of how I approached empowerment this month. So super fun. But again, thank you everyone for joining us. If you have to leave, by all means, if you want to stick around and you have more questions, let us know. I'll be cycling back through some of those slides. So chime in if you definitely want us to go back to the slides. We'll hang out a little bit longer just to make sure everyone's questions get answered. So again, thank you guys for joining us on a long weekend. We hope to see you guys again. Thank you. Bye.
my chest where nobody else can see. Yeah. I'm a fool.